Tomorrow it is Christmas, the first for you and me. Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are all very, very well. In today's video, I wanted to share with you what I am putting in my boys' Christmas Eve / 1st of December box. I'm actually giving them all of this on the 1st of December so that they have got lots of crafts and little treats to have throughout of December. And then on Christmas Eve, I'll give them just a couple of things, like just the plate and things to put out for Santa, all that sort of thing. I did this last year and it worked really well. And obviously, I just want to make sure that they have a really special Christmas because it's all going to be so different. So I have put together a ton of things that I just know that any child would love. So if you are looking for some ideas of what to put in these kind of boxes for your children, then keep watching. So if you don't know, I have three boys. I have a 9-year-old, a 7-year-old, and a 5-year-old. So this is for all three of them, and I'm going to go through each item and just show you what I've been gathering and collecting and buying. Some of them you will have maybe seen before actually, because they are in Home Bargains or B&M hauls, because that is where a lot of this stuff is from. I just want to start by talking about this box actually. How nice is this? I will show you the lid when I've emptied everything out of it. But this was from Home Bargains. They did it in three sizes. I got the biggest size. I think it was around £8, but I thought this would just work really well as a 1st of December box, because they have Christmas Eve boxes, but obviously they say on them don't open until the 24th of December. So I thought this was nice because it doesn't say anything like that on it. It just says Merry Christmas at the top. And I thought these really nice little traditional drawings of the ballerina and the nutcracker, I just thought it was a really sweet box that I can use every year for them. So inside, I'm going to start taking things out because it is just overflowing with stuff. I'm not going to lie, I've gone a little bit crazy this year, but I just kept seeing things. There probably is more in here than they'll actually get on Christmas Day. But yeah, let's just start pulling things out. So you will have maybe seen, if you have seen my Home Bargains haul, one of them, one of many, I bought these decorations for the boys. So every year I get them a different decoration for them to put on their tree upstairs. So this year I spotted these in Home Bargains and got them each one. So there is this hot air balloon with Santa in it. These were about £1.50 each. And I thought they're really nice special ones. Ice cream, because Archie loves ice cream. And then Tobes did some drumming at school, which he loved, and we got him a little drum. So yeah, £1.50 each, and I just tend to give them a decoration, like I say, every year for them to put on their tree. It's a really nice idea if you do something that sort of represents something that they've done that year. Maybe if they've done a hobby, ballet, football or something, and get them a decoration to remind them of the year that has just gone. Maybe if you've taken a special trip somewhere, holidays or anything, then I always think that's a really nice idea for a little keepsake. So every year I put one of these in for them. It is one of these electric toothbrushes. These were just from Home Bargains, a couple of pounds each. I got two superhero ones for Toby and Dylan, and then, which is it? Is it a PJ mask? Yeah, and a PJ mask one for Archie. I always think it's nice to get little things like this, especially on Christmas Eve actually, where they've got a new toothbrush. You get them a nice bath bomb. I normally get mine a Lush bath bomb, like a special one, and then new washcloths, which I've got in there as well. Just nice things for them to have a really nice little pamper before they go to bed. So yeah, I always get them new toothbrushes. So as I said about washcloths, I just picked these up, but these were about 50p 60p, something like that, from Home Bargains, and I got them three different designs. So one can have the reindeer, one can have the elf, and one can have Santa. One idea that I had this year that I haven't done before, but I just decided that this is going to be a great thing for us this year, because we're probably not going to be doing that much throughout December, is this little movie jar. So I've just put a little bit of snow in the bottom of one of these mason jars. You can pick these up about 70p from Home Bargains. I've got quite a few of them that I use for like breakfast and things. But yeah, we just put a bit of artificial snow in, and then I have written different Christmas films on little pieces of paper here. So when we are bored in the house and we want to have a nice family film night, which we do a lot, I just filled it with Christmas movies. So we've got Home Alone 2, we've got The Christmas Chronicles, we've got loads of different family films that we can just pick out and pop on the telly, get some snacks, get snuggled up, and yeah, full of Christmas films. You could do this any time of year, to be honest. I just thought it's a really nice thing to do throughout December. We love having a little movie night, so the kids are gonna love that. Another great thing to include is lots of Christmas serveware. So I have included this before in a haul that I got from Home Bargains. It is this really cute little mug and bowl set that I picked up for Archie. I don't think the bowl's going to be quite big enough for Toby and Dylan for their breakfast, but I picked that up for Archie, and then I get these out every year. These are Toby and Dylan's little elf mugs that they have had since they were really little, and yeah, we try to have Christmas themed serveware for most meals and drinks and things. So I've got more to dig out of the bags and boxes of decorations. They love using special cups and things that are Christmassy, so these are just little elf mugs, again from Home Bargains. I know I say that for everything, but I just think they're the best when it comes to this sort of stuff for Christmas. You definitely can't go wrong in Home Bargains. They just get it right with everything. So yeah, I think another great thing to include is lots of Christmas serveware, Christmas mugs, bowls, Christmas cups, just all of that stuff, just to make it that little bit more special. We have also got these that I showed in one of my hauls as well. These are amazing, these little hot chocolate like bombs. So they're snowmen that are full of chocolate chips and marshmallows, and you just put them in hot milk. So I know that Dylan and Archie are gonna love having them one night. Tobes doesn't like chocolate, but I think they are a great little treat for one night, especially if we get in from the school run and it is all wet and cold outside. Then I love making the boys a hot chocolate and put the fire on, and yeah, we can snuggle up in our pajamas with a nice hot chocolate. And to go with them, which again was in one of my hauls, is these marshmallow toppers to go on top of the hot chocolates. These are a box of six. I've yet to try them, but I'm sure they're going to be really nice. I think they're like sugar coated, so yeah, they just go on the top of the hot chocolate. So the boys are gonna love them. And I also have included a box of these that I got from Home Bargains again. These are little mug huggers, so they just sit on the edge of the mug, and the boys are gonna love them. They are really, really cute. You get Santa, Rudolph, a penguin, and a gingerbread man, and they're about £1.50 for four. I've also just included some other little treats and snacks. These are great for when we have any of these film nights that we have got planned. I've put in a few things that we don't normally have. That's what I tend to do, and then obviously I'll probably get a bag of popcorn or something to include in there as well. But I got these American candies, so these are Mike and Ike, so we've never had these before, so I'm sure the boys will love trying these. They were just from B&M, and also these were from B&M as well, these red vines, just some American candies. You can get some really cool gift boxes of American candies in B&M. I did spot them and did think about getting them, but I thought I'm just going to get these two because these I know that the boys haven't tried. So I think it's always nice to put some treats in there and put in a few things that you don't always have. So if you were doing it for grown-ups, then put in some nice like fancier things. Like you could put in some nice beef jerky, some fancy luxury bags of honeycomb or marshmallows. Like just put in things that are a real treat. And I also got these for Tobes. These are some reindeer nose marshmallows. These are sugar coated strawberry marshmallows, again from Home Bargains, of course. Where else would they be from? I also picked up one of these, which is going to be a really fun little activity for one day when we're at a bit of a loose end. It is this gingerbread men making kit. So you have got this little cutter on the front, and all you need for it is a bit of butter and water. So that'll be a fun little activity for us to do to make the whole house smell like gingerbread cookies. Oh, I just, yeah, I mean, is it for the kids or is it for me? But I'm going to enjoy doing this with them. Thought it'd be quite nice for as a family this year if we did some jigsaw puzzles. So I picked up this from The Works. This was £5 and it is a 500 piece Christmas jigsaw. I just thought it'd be quite a nice little thing for us to all do together. The boys enjoy doing puzzles. I think me and Peter were going to enjoy doing it as well. So we can all sit down as a family with our nice hot chocolates and do a little Christmas puzzle. And I just got an easier one for Archie so he can have a go at doing his own if he finds that one a little bit difficult. This again was from The Works. I think this was £2 or maybe £3, but this is just a 45 piece Christmas one. We absolutely love playing card games in this house. The boys are obsessed with playing Go Fish. We need to learn some new games actually, but these are giant cards that they do in Home Bargains. They do an even bigger set actually. I think they do like A4 size, but the boys lose cards quite easily, so these were really inexpensive and a little bit fun, so we can also have lots of card games throughout December. I've seen loads of people with this on Instagram, and it is just this cute little envelope for them to put their letter to Santa in it, so they can put this again on their tree upstairs and then write their letter out, which is another great thing to do as a family. Sit down and get them to write their letters to Santa. They can do their Christmas lists, put it in the envelope and put it on their tree. So I just thought that was really cute and makes a nice decoration as well. I also picked these up for a couple of pounds each. These are some magic Christmas trees and magic snowmen. So as far as I know, I think you just add water and it sort of like grows this fluffy stuff on it. I'm not 100% sure. So it says it grows in 12 hours. That's just going to be a little fun thing that we can do, and it makes a little decoration as well. I'm sure they're going to love that. This is something else that we tend to do every year, to be honest. Even though nobody seems to really eat it, it's always a really fun activity. So I got this. This was £5 from B&M. So just a make your own gingerbread house. There is pretty much everything I think that you need in here. I don't think you need to add anything to it, although I may buy some little extra sweets and things for us to decorate it with, but that is another really good family activity, and yeah, just one that we seem to do every year. I also always add in these sorts of things in their hampers, so the kids' Christmas crackers. There's nothing much in them, to be honest. They're always quite basic. They weren't very expensive at all, but they obviously just love to pull a cracker, so I've got some more of these actually, and these are just really fun for them, and I'm going to put some on their tree as well, and they could do them as and when they want. I'm not sure what's inside them. Probably a little joke and a hat, but they just love things like that, so that is always a nice little extra to add in as well. I don't think any Christmas Eve hamper is complete without new pajamas. I mean, Christmas Eve is normally when I give them their new pajamas, but I thought it's going to be better for them to have their Christmas pajamas for the whole of December. I've actually bought us all matching ones as well. These were all from Home Bargains. So I got them offline and I managed to get us all the right size, which is amazing, because every year I have this battle to get family Christmas pajamas, and I'll find some that I like and I'll be going through getting everybody's size, and then there's always one that's not available. So I was amazed that there was all ones in our size on the website. These I haven't seen them in store, but yeah, these are a really nice pattern as well, and they're not too Christmassy, so they can still wear them. I mean, we wear Christmas pajamas all year round, to be honest. Like, we will get the use out of them whether they had Merry Christmas all over them, but they're not dead Christmassy. So for Tobes and Dill, their design is like this checked trouser. The one that I've got is the trousers and the shirt, and then they do them with just this blue top. So Tobes and Dill have got this, and so is Peter with the check trousers, just this nice blue plain top. And then me and Archie have got ones with the shirt, and I've already worn mine and I can confirm they're actually really nice quality. So the boys ones were £6.99 each, and then I think the adult ones for me and Peter were £11.99 each. So I didn't think that was that bad either. And like I say, they're pajamas that can be worn all the time, and they just really, they do feel really soft, really nice quality. So I'm really, really pleased with them. And then another thing is some Christmas socks. So these were £3 and there are 6 pairs here. These were from B&M. I didn't want to end up having absolutely loads of Christmas socks, but I do think it is nice to just have a few pairs. So yeah, 6 pairs that are in there for £3. And then the last item that I like to put in there, we already have these, they've got one each of these, is a Christmas throw. So this is another little nice extra to put in there. Baskets and hampers, because it's just something that they can snuggle up with. So when they've used their new toothbrush and they've got their hot chocolate in their Christmas mug in their new pajamas, then they can snuggle up watching a Christmas film with their Christmas throw. All of these items I think do tie in quite nicely. So yeah, these were, I think they were from, I got them a couple of years ago, I think they were from Asda. Asda actually have some really nice throws at the minute, about £6, not that expensive, and the boys absolutely love having their Christmas ones. So I will be changing all their bedding over to Christmas bedding and they will have their throws on their bed. Yeah, really lovely little idea for gifts as well as putting in Christmas Eve hampers. And then I just want to show you this box. So this is the top of it. and it obviously just says Merry Christmas. I think it is a really classic, lovely little design, and yeah, it's a massive size, so it's going to fit all of this stuff in really nicely. And like I say, about £8 I think from Home Bargains. I was really, really pleased to find that. Another little thing that I've decided to do this year that I've not done before, but I'm really excited for, is to wrap up 24 Christmas books for them to open one every day for us to read together. So I went on the Works website and I picked up a load of Christmas books. So they do the 10 for £10 books. So I've got a big bundle there of all the Christmas books, some really nice ones as well. None, obviously we don't have any of these. So I'm really excited that I'm gonna wrap them all up, put them in a basket under the tree, and then each day they can pick one, and then that night we can read it together. And I also got some more from the Works here. I think these were 6 for £10. So some really cute looking books, some that I just think they're gonna love. We've even got the snowman and the snow dog. I'm just really excited to sit and do that with them every night. And then if any other Christmas books that we already have, I'm just gonna wrap up so that we can read again as well. So I haven't bought 24 because I'm gonna use some that we already have, because it's just, you know, we may as well do that. And then a lot of these I can use again for next year, because this is obviously the time of year that we're gonna read them. So I'm really excited to do that for them. And then for their advent calendars, which they will also get on the first, I picked these up today. So they have got 3 of these Haribo ones. They are normally around £5, but these were actually on offer in B&M today. I think they were like £3.50, so I thought, oh, I'm gonna get them. And yeah, we just picked up the sweet ones, because generally Toby, obviously, like I've said before, doesn't like chocolate, and then when he gets a sweet one, it normally means that the other two wish that they'd had a sweets one. So I just got 3 of these just to save any arguments. So I am pretty much all set now for the 1st of December for them to have all these goodies. And we will see whether the elf makes a return as well. That's actually going to be my next video. I'm going to be sharing loads of different ideas for elves for them to get up to when they come and visit. So if you were wondering what the elves might get up to this year, then make sure you watch my next one. So I'm going to go and pack all this back away in its box again, ready for the 1st of December. And I just really hope that you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you some ideas if you were looking for any ideas for these sorts of boxes. And I would love it if you subscribed to my channel. I am loving doing all these Christmas videos at the moment. I'm in my absolute element. I'm just obsessed, Christmas crazy. So make sure you give it a big thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and hit the subscribe button if you are not already subscribed, and I will see you again for my next one. Take care, everyone. Bye.